Hey everyone. In this video, I'll be installing the Comet server on Linux. I'll be using Ubuntu 18 in this example, but you can still follow the same steps on Debian. Firstly, download the Comet server dev package. You can find this on cometbackup.com/downloads. And in this one, I'm going to download Ubuntu. Okay, now locate the downloads folder and we want to install the dev package, so open up a terminal. Make sure you have superuser privileges. And install using this command. Okay, now for the serial number, you want to go to your account and go to My Servers. And then just simply click Add Server, and we want a Comet Enterprise server, so go ahead and name our server. And our serial will be there. So just grab that one and put that in there. Okay, the Comet server has installed. Keep in mind for the installation command, make sure the version numbers here are the same as the numbers in the dev package that you have downloaded. Alright, and to check the status of our Comet server, I'm going to use the systemctl status command. As you can see, the Comet server is not running at the moment. We will use systemctl start for that. Okay, and now we can check the status, and right here you can see now it's active, and you can see the recent server logs. If I maximize that, you can see there. And to edit the config file, I'm going to use the nano command. The config file will be located in /etc/cometd. Directory. Okay, and this is the config file. As you can see, my serial number is here. You can configure the branding from here, your admin account, your interface address. And as you can see, by default, it's given us just a localhost address. And so what we can do here is go to our server right now on the browser to access our web interface and actually configure the Comet server from within there instead if you want to use the GUI. If you misconfigure your server and unable to access the web interface, make sure your config is configured correctly. See mine and compare what might be different. Sometimes it can be as simple as an extra space or colon. Now I'm going to open up a browser and access our Comet server with the default local host address. And I'm going to use the default username and password admin. If you've set yours up, then log in with that one. And you will be able to change the password for this account within here as well. As you can see, this is the dashboard, and since this is a new server, there will be a short guide here for you. You can configure your Comet server by going to the setup wizard. And in here, you can set up your server. You can see server branding. You can also do client branding as well. Email reporting. And this is where you set up your network interface. As you can see, this is just the default one at the moment. But if you go into here and you want to configure SSL, yeah, you can go ahead and do that. We also have our automatic option, which lets you set up your SSL really easily by simply putting in your public host name and then you change the port here to 443, and that is basically it. All you need is to have the ports 443 and 80 open on your network to your Comet server and a public hostname. And what that'll do is we are integrated with Let's Encrypt, so Comet will automatically grab a SSL certificate from Let's Encrypt, and when that needs to be updated, it will also automatically be updated. So there's no need to worry about your SSL. Very easy. This is where you can set up your admin accounts and change the username passwords. Now, I'm not going to go into too much detail with the rest of the setup wizard, as this video is about getting your Linux server installed and running. Please see our other video that goes into more detail about configuring your Comet server, which will be linked in the description. Once you have gone through the setup wizard and made some changes, if you go back to your config file, you will see that the changes you pushed through from the web interface have been applied. You can configure your Comet server either way, or whatever is easier for you. If you want to know more technical information, please see on our website our documentation, and thank you for watching our video.